Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JR from PTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create the Instagram logo in Photoshop. But in reality, I should have titled this video, "Can you believe someone actually got paid thousands of dollars to create this?" As you might be able to tell, I'm not a big fan of the new logo, but I do like the new interface, so I guess it's not all bad. Also, I want to mention that my friend Howard Pinsky beat me to the punch and posted a tutorial on this new logo just a few hours ago, so I figured that I would throw him a shout out in this video and ask you to check out his version of recreating this logo. You can watch his tutorial on his YouTube channel. I'll leave a link to it in the description. But anyway, let's get started with the tutorial. Okay, so we have a canvas that's 1350 by 1350, and I'm going to start by creating a couple guides in the center of the canvas. I'm going to select the rounded rectangle tool. Then I'm going to click on the center and drag a rectangle as I hold Alt and Shift. That's Option Shift on the Mac, so that the rectangle is created from the center and it maintains its proportions. The rectangle is 800 by 800 pixels. Black is the fill color. I'm going to change the roundness to 183 pixels. Then I'm going to create another rounded rectangle. Click, drag, hold Alt, Shift again, and this rounded rectangle will be 600 pixels. And the roundness is going to be 168. And this one will not have a fill color, but will have a stroke of white. And the stroke width will be 60 pixels. Then I'm going to select the ellipse tool. Once again, click in the center and create a circle that is 310 pixels. And this circle takes the stroke of 60 pixels we had before, so that's fine. Then we're going to create another circle in between these two shapes. I'm going to click, then hold Shift, and create a circle that's 75 pixels. Press V on the keyboard and move this in between the two shapes, right about there. And now we're going to do the hard part, which is add the color. And in reality, it's really not that hard. I'm going to double click on the side of the layer here, the original rectangle, the black one, and click on Gradient Overlay. I have the default gradients. If I click on this drop-down menu, you'll see them there. If you don't have them, you can click on Reset Gradients and click on this gradient here on the right. Select Radial under Style, and then click on Reverse. We want the yellow in the inside. Then you can click and drag these colors around. So we want the yellow here at the bottom. And scale it up all the way to 150% and uncheck Align with Layer. What we need to do now is just make a few quick adjustments. So I'm going to double click on the gradient here, and we need to have pink instead of red. So I'm just going to click on this swatch and select the pinkish magenta color I see here. And we need more of that. So I'm going to click and drag this to the left. And the blue is a little strong. So I'm going to double click on the swatch and reduce its intensity to something like that and press OK. Press OK once again. Then I'm going to press Control H, Command H on the Mac to hide the guides. And there you go, the new Instagram logo. You see? Can you believe someone actually got paid thousands of dollars for this? I say that half jokingly, of course. I know that a lot of different designs were created and a lot of research went into creating this new logo. It wasn't as simple as I made it seem in the tutorial, but I'm still disappointed. Let me know what you think of the new logo. Leave your comments and questions below. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at JR from PTC. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.